My dear light bulbs, to another Jogging Review. If you're a new viewer to my channel, remember to subscribe to become part of the light bulb army. So this chapter of Jogging was very, very crazy. This dude, Robot Hata, is the pinnacle of evil. Remember that SpongeBob episode where Barnacle Boy and Mermaid Man and Mermaid Man always used to say evil, like he just stressed it out so much? That is Robot Hata in a nutshell. The first point I want to talk about is Misogi scene, the name of it, with the Fractured Human Warriors uniting and stuff. The Super Friends, now let me stop playing. They're actually called the Hiwa Happiness Heroes. Really crappy name, but whatever. Or for sure, the Triple H's, and that's it. Very bad name for a team. That is like so corny, but hey, whatever, as long as this works. And they're actually quite popular. Like, the civilians are like, yes, they're helping us in the Boopa district and all this stuff, which is cool because Misogi has achieved something. One, he has achieved popularity. Two, he's striving for peace, right? So I believe if we get this far, if all the fractured humans, the regular ones, get destroyed, Misogi's next mission is not going to be, oh, that's it, we're done, that's it. No, Misogi's next mission is probably going to be like, hey, I still want world peace, and I may use force to accomplish this goal, even though that's like counterproductive, because if he used violence to achieve peace, is it really peace or is it fear? And oh man, that is just an interesting question. And by that time, I don't know what happens yet in the story, because this story is adapted from, I believe, a light novel or something. But if Misogi is striving for peace, I have a feeling that the Triple H's team is going to get bigger later on with more fractured human warriors, if there's more in Japan. If not, then that's going to be the roster for now. But I also have the feeling that they're going to encounter a regular fractured human that is way stronger than the Beastified fractured human that gave Yagasaki so much trouble that basically Shiharu took him down with his like tree roots and stuff. So I believe there's gonna be like some ultimate fractured thing that is like maybe a gigantic thing that is very solid and very hard to destroy. So that's that. Also, before back on that point, with popularity, if Misogi wants to achieve peace and he's like saying his ideals to the people of Japan, they will be for him. He could potentially become the president of Japan or something. That would be really interesting. Even if the government opposes him, the people will be behind him. They will rally behind him because of his popularity and because they see him as doing a good thing in society. Now, the second point I want to talk about, Robot Hata, I already said many chapters back when he first raped Karen, I was like, this dude crossed the line. Like, there's a line, really? Like, there's a line. If you cross over that line, that's it. Your character is not redeemable no matter what you do. Only certain characters are in that cross the line. An example is from Berserk Griffith. I'm not going to spoil anything, but Griffith crossed the line. Now, this dude is like, oh, my hobby is chasing women. This dude's out here raping almost every, like, woman he wants. Well, any woman he wants. And I'm like, this dude is sick. And it is disgusting that he's using his fractured human warrior power for evil. Which, this is actually the first time we have seen a fractured human warrior doing this. You might say, oh, wait. What about Shiharu? Shiharu does things because he's selfish. But we haven't seen anything from Shiharu where he just killing random civilians or anything like that. The most he did was create a giant tree in the middle of the city and stuff, which I think he defeated a fractured human or whatever with the tree. But that was it. But in the case of Robot Hata, this dude's doing some villainous things, some disgusting things. And basically, he was watching the program with Misogi in there. And this shows that Robot Hata does not care about his action. He doesn't think there's going to be consequences. So the more he's just going with his desires more and more and more and more, and eventually that frenzy frog is gonna take over Robohata's mind. And you gotta realize that the frenzy frog that's inside of Robohata, it had a tadpole tail. If you go a few chapters back and do see that, so it's gonna be progressing faster than the tadpoles that is inside of Yagasaki. We still don't know if there's a tadpole inside of Shiharu or the others, Fraction Human Warriors, because there's no explanation, but it could be implied. But in the case of Robohata, no, this dude has like almost a full-grown frog, and the progression is becoming even faster because he just keeps diving into his desires more and more. And he's like, I do whatever I want, which shows Robohata is a very cocky, has a very cocky personality, doesn't care about consequences, and his character is just very disgusting. Now, towards the end of this chapter, what he did to that dude's sister, her name, the name of the sister was Nanami, I forgot the guy's name, just for revenge, just because he thought him and Karen were a couple or something, which they weren't, they were just dating. If you're just dating someone a couple of times, that's not your girlfriend, dude. Like, what is wrong with Robohata? This, I wish I was in this manga. We gotta hunt down Robohata. I cannot wait till he fully loses control and goes berserk. So maybe either Yagasaki or Misogi destroys him completely, because this guy has no remorse of the actions he has done. You might say, oh, maybe it's a frenzy frog already taking over his mind. No. In the beginning, when he was with Karin, he was really angered. That was him doing that. He's still conscious of what he does. He laughs about the activities he does to all these women, which shows it's him in control. If he was not in control, you know what would happen? He would just go attacking random women in the streets, raping them and stuff like that. No, this guy is in control right now of his own body and mind, and he still continues doing these disgusting acts. And that was very, very dark of what he did to the dude's sister towards the end. He even made a video about it and put it on the screen for the dude to watch. That would just break that brother's psyche if he does watch that video. That's gonna scar him for life, and that's what Robohata was planning all along, which is just disgusting. Now I'm rooting for Robohata to turn completely into a fractured human, so he could be taken out by the Triple H's. I forgot the name of them already. It's so weird. I think he was. Whatever. It doesn't matter. So overall, the chapter was really good. The pacing was really good. This chapter was more Robohata centric. It focused more on him. It was a very dark chapter as well, and it shows that. It was also like a message, like, what if you attained this power? What will you do with it? Which, no, a lot of people would be the Robohata, which I wouldn't. I wouldn't even want that power. That's just wrong, basically. So overall, I'm gonna give this chapter a 9 out of 10. I know you're watching this, Perm. I know you're watching this. Great chapter, Jagen. Hope you stay to the end. Really long review, but have a great day. Peace.